Let's also look at examples of what happens when we change the lens that has a different focal length. Let's look at the example we've looked at before, a tree, a lens, and an image of a lens here. Of course, let's assume that this lens has a focal length of 3 inches. So this time around, I'm only going to change the lens and give it another lens with a different focal length. So now we have another lens. This lens has a focal length of, say, 6 inches. Remember, we want the image to be formed at the focal plane of this lens. So now, the best image that will be formed at this focal length, because of the fact that it's farther away, would be larger than this one. So just by changing the lens focal length, we notice that the image formed is much bigger. So this allows us to now basically be able to control how we form images on our sensor. By changing the focal length, we can actually play around and generate different types of images. And most times, the focal length f could be longer or shorter. And we'll see examples of the impact of this on what kinds of images are formed in a bit. Now remember, focal lengths are specific to lenses themselves when they're manufactured. Most of the times, of course, when you see complex lenses, you also get a variety of lenses composited together, and the dynamics of these lenses are the ones that give you the effective focal length of that lens. In this case, of course, we're just simplifying all of our lenses to be just one simple lens here.